Hello everyone, my name is Amelia and I'm a Product Advocacy Lead for ArcGIS Prev.
And I'm Vivian, a Product Readiness Lead. We're here to talk about the new features that were added to ArcGIS Pro 2.9.
This compilation, created by the ArcGIS Pro development teams, shows the new functionality and improvements made to ArcGIS Pro 2.9. Let's look at the top 10 new features coming to Pro 2.9. Cloud Data Warehouse Support. We added the support of three cloud data warehouses, Snowflake, Google BigQuery, and Amazon Redshift. Users can work with large data warehouse tables in Pro. With a feature binning tool, for example, users can visualize spatially aggregated attribute values from marine data collected by vessels to build a sea surface temperature map, or to visualize geometric distribution of taxi usage patterns from New York City taxi data. Users can also perform SQL query-based analysis using query layers to visualize analysis results, like this traffic jams map of Raleigh, North Carolina, from millions of traffic data collected on road segments. Maps built with data from a cloud data warehouse can also be published as a map service.
Knowledge graphs. Knowledge graphs in a link chart can help reveal communities and hierarchies in your data. Using full-text search, discover entities and relationships by their property value. With fine paths, discover relationships between selected entities and expand to uncover more of your connected data. Algorithms like centrality can help you identify influential assets in your network, which can be visualized using familiar tools. Add knowledge graph layers into your map and discover the new relationships between your spatial and non-spatial data.
Dynamic feature clustering. For this release, you can apply dynamic feature clustering to a point feature layer. Using the Clustering Ribbon tab, you can change settings like clustering radius to adjust the map pattern. Add new summary fields based on the original field from the layer. Use the symbology pane to change cluster symbology types and add a different summary field. You can also set cluster text using a summary field or an arcade expression and update the cluster text style. Clicking on a cluster will show a pop-up. A cluster layer can also be published to ArcGIS Online.
Animated symbols. Pro now supports animated symbols through GLTF 3D models and animated GIF picture marker symbols. You can pause the animated symbols in the map and connect display properties, such as playback duration, to attributes and expressions, so that each feature can animate at its own speed. Pro includes two styles with animated symbols, one for 3D models and one for animated GIFs, making it easy to start working with this new symbology option.
Linear referencing user interface. The new linear referencing ribbon displays when an MAware layer is present in an active map. The ribbon simplifies completing common linear referencing workflows. Other equivalency items completed include assigning a route ID to a layer, find routes, and display route events from the table of contents.
PDF to TIFF. ArcGIS Pro 2.9 introduces the PDF to TIFF tool. This tool is especially useful for converting a georeferenced PDF file into a GeoTIFF file, which can be added to a map as a raster dataset. A variety of options are available in the tool, including which page of the PDF to convert to TIFF and choosing which map in the PDF you would like to use for referencing the GeoTIFF. In this case, the largest map will be used. Once the tool has been run, the newly created GeoTIFF is added to the current map.
Presence-only prediction. The new presence-only prediction tool models the presence of a phenomenon using known presence locations, explanatory variables, and a maximum entropy approach, or maxent. It can be used to model presence of a species or any phenomenon where presence is known, but absence is not. The tool incorporates data preparation workflows, such as variable transformation and spatial thinning. It also provides model validation capabilities, including cross-validation to evaluate predictions and partial response charts to examine the effect of each explanatory variable on presence probabilities.
There are several performance and productivity enhancements in ArcGIS Pro 2.9. For example, There are new options for browsing in the catalog pane and view. You can choose to see the full path of a folder connection as its name. You can also provide an alias for a folder connection. In the catalog pane, you can add an alias using the context menu. You are no longer restricted to only opening table views from content within the map. You can now open a table view or feature class directly from the catalog pane or catalog view, and that table view is fully functional for viewing and editing.
Improvements in the graphics system have resulted in up to a 35% increase in frame rates for label-rich scenes, such as a few cities in the Los Angeles area. Multi-threading improvements in the terrain system have resulted in up to a 94% increase in performance while loading the terrain surface.
New tools have been added for converting graphics to features and features to graphics. Here we convert lines to a feature class. You can also convert text graphics to annotation feature classes. When converting features to graphics, select the input layer and the features will be converted with their full symbolization. Solving OD cost matrix analyses in Python using the arcpy.nax solver objects is 20 to 80% faster in 2.9. Additionally, some extremely large problems that were unsolvable in 2.8 are now solvable in 2.9.
Change point detection.
The change point detection tool detects changes in time series values at each location of a space-time cube. The tool can detect changes in mean or standard deviation for continuous variables and changes in mean for count variables. The number of change points can be detected automatically at each location, or you can specify a defined number of change points that will be detected at every location. The output layer includes interactive pop-up charts that display the time series at each location with indicators of the change points and the mean value or standard deviation of each segment between the change points.
Legend and table styles. Support has been added for table and legend styles and layouts. You can now add a legend or table directly from a style. Once a table or legend has been added, you can also change its style. You can also change the style of the accompanying legend items or of the table frame fields. And that was the top 10 of what's coming to Pro 2.9.
Thank you for watching.